for trying to machine to do have a computation. It doesn't just sort of bring up into that in a mathematical way. Diagram or a schematic of trying to machine, and that particular string is following the edges. And following the edges means that the machine is doing a computation on that string, and this is a formal description of what it means to do a computation. All of this on finite-state machines is all this terminology and formalisms is part of what is necessary when we ultimately get to a description of a whole computer. Okay, finite-state machines are sort of descriptions of to some extent what's happening in a processor when you kind of ignore the memory that's available to a machine. Okay, what is next? Okay, this is a design. Let's do the opposite. So instead of looking at a finite state machine and asking what is the language that it accepts, let's start with the language and see if we can design a finite state machine for it. Okay, so let's take this signal again to be binary. And the language, so when I design a machine M that accepts the language A, that is all strings with an odd number of ones. Okay? So take a minute. Yeah, okay, so I had in mind, because I cheated and got it from the book, I had in mind a different solution, but the question, first of all, is does this work? Okay, then why not? 0, 1, 0, so you put 0, 1, 0, you end up in Q1 and you reject. Okay, so it looks like this one is not quite right. More formal. Okay, all right, so I think the homework question is how you're doing some design. And this is a puzzle. This is a puzzle, really. This just take a little time to do. All right, so now that we have a fairly clear idea of what a finite state machine is, both formally and informally, and we have a little bit of design, there are things that we can prove about finite state machines. And in particular, there are things called regular operations. Regular operations. So, one is called union. So, oh, actually, I need to use one more term. Sorry. One more term here. Definition. A language that is accepted, recognized by some deterministic finite state machine, which is called a regular language. Okay. All right. And then what we're doing is regular operations, which is union over regular languages. Okay, so this is a theorem. Last submission. Define union first. So, A and B are regular languages. Okay. Well, each language is a set of strings. So these are sets. Okay, A is a set of strings, B is a set of strings. It happens to be that A is a set of strings that's recognized by some deterministic finite state machine, and B is a set of strings that's recognized by some deterministic finite state machine. Okay, then this is a set. So what kind of things can you do with sets? You can take unions, you can make intersections, you can make differences. Exclusive or difference. And you can do all kinds of things with sets. You learned that in high school. So you can think about the set A union B. Okay, that's the set of strings that are either in A or in B, or maybe they're in both. Okay, so we can ask, you know, is A union B a regular language? And the theorem is yes. So if A and B are regular, then A union B is regular. Okay. That's the theorem. That's something we can prove. Now, is that really clear in what I'm stating? Again, think about A as a set of strings, and B as a set of strings. It happens to be a set of strings that's recognized by some finite state machine, and B is a set of strings recognized by a finite state machine. But because they're sets, they can be union, and so we can think about A union B, and this theorem says that if A and B are regular languages, then A union B is also a regular language. Okay, how do you prove that? Well, that's the only way we know so far to know whether a language is regular. Recognized by some deterministic finite state machine. That's the only way we know so far. We're building out some tools. But so far, no possible way of observing or program in a particular language is regular by showing deterministic Clayson machine that actually recognizes that language. Okay. So we want a deterministic Clayson machine that recognizes A and B. And on the assumption that A is a regular language and B is a regular language, we know what about them.
Because
set of strings, but I'm claiming that this is not a regular language. You can try to build a finite-state machine for this, but you should fail. Okay, and in a couple of lectures, we'll actually prove that there is no finite-state machine that can recognize this language. Okay, so sit with that if you have time, and that will build up your intuition in the virtual